Some journey for you, Shenazz, from Yakul and Hong Kong. Of course, the angel would love to know that you were part of Taal, Pardes, and Pardes. Are you sure the angels Yakul are part one? I'm sure they will go away.
Absolutely.
Or maybe the angels would love to, they'll cling to you even more then, yeah. So, all I have to say is congratulations. This was long overdue. And so happy and so impressed with the kind of support that we're getting. It just shows how good you are in connecting people with what they want to connect with and helping them with their lives. And you'll always be a friend. You'll always be my guide, irrespective of whether you know you're into the angels or not. But this is priceless. I can vouch for that. Congrats again.
Thank you, Isha. Thank you.
Good evening, all the agents present here. Shenazz, Roshani Shenazz. Well, I knew Shenazz 10 years ago during Yakul Hum. I guess the Roshani comes from the light that you're spreading into the universe. Excellent, superb work. I do believe in angels. I do believe in the supreme superpower. I know their energy is around us, and I talk to them all the time. I feel so blessed this evening that I'm a part of this gathering. And Shenazz, I got a call suddenly from you out of the blue after such a long time and for something like this. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Isha. Thank you.
Good evening. From a very boisterous Shenazz in Pardes to someone who came outside my store and told me I'm transiting from this worldly potential into something more serious and about angels as well. It's okay. After which I didn't see her for a while, and then suddenly these messages started coming on my phone. I was like, is she okay? What is all this going on? And yes, we all do read, and we all get guided by spiritual powers and angels. And then I suddenly started taking her messages slightly more seriously. And it's so strange that every time there was an issue that I had in my head and I didn't know how to solve it, it's weird, but the message that came would solve that entire problem and it would go away. So yes, she is like an angel, like a guiding light, and congratulations, Shenazz, on this book. I have been through this last evening and this morning, and it is absolutely brilliant. So congratulations, and wish you a lot of success on whatever you're doing by guiding everyone.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Do guardian angels really exist? I believe they do from last night, because I rang up Shenazz last night and I told her, I have a terrible, terrible cough. I don't think I'll be able to speak today. He said, don't worry, I'm there for you. The guardian angels are there for you. You will be able to speak. And the very fact that I can't speak now, you wouldn't believe it, my cough and my sore throat was so bad, I was croaking last night. And my husband told me, you didn't cough at all last night. What happened? So he said, well, Roshani gave it to my life. It is true, guardian angels do exist. And
Shenazz has been helping our teachers. I run many schools through the KCUD colleges, KCHR, Gen, and all those colleges. So Shenazz has been training our teachers and all the schools that looks after the underprivileged children, the children who are victims of women trafficking and the red light area, the fumes and driver's children. So she trains the teachers of that school, and they were so impacted by how you train them. They keep asking for more. So Shenazz, I'll be calling you to all our colleges, and I'll put this book up in our college library.
Wow. Sitting there, she tells me that, look, Poonam aunty, you should have asked for the moon. And you want the book, you want it. I said, I don't want the moon. I've got what I wanted. Just now.
Shenazz, I know you for a very long time, and she has been sending messages just like to the rest of us, and I of course haven't experienced this entire journey what most of you all have, and I'm really curious and inquisitive and excited to be a part of this wonderful journey, and I'm going to start up with this right away. Congratulations, darling.
So I think our lives have been touched by angels forever, but now we get to know, yes, we have our own guardian angels. Thank you so much. I'd like you to please take your seats. Yes, ma'am. Absolutely.
I just want to say how proud we are to have brought out this book and have been associated with it. I'm so very proud of Roshani and Shenazz, who I've known ever since I think she moved into the spiritual world. I don't really know her
previous life, previous avatar.
Previous avatar. But I'm seeing evidence of it all over. And I think it's wonderful that, you know, I mean, that she was able to leave this very glamorous background and take this flying leap into something as uncertain as spirituality. It calls for a tremendously strong mind and some and deep inspiration. And I think that inspiration is behind all her manifest works and this beautiful book, and I'm sure there will be plenty more books, and I hope Life Positive produces all of them.
Absolutely, ma'am. Thank you.
Keep going, Shenazz. Hearty congratulations from all of us.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much. When we have so much of strife, so much of violence, so much of disturbance, so much of pain, what does positivity really mean? For some, it just means probably what?
You think positivity is our perception of what we see around us? It's something that's most internal, it can't be external, because you can't change the external world, and that is not in our control, but how we perceive it, how we what we do with it, and what we let ourselves go through eventually is what positivity is about, and that's within our control. So I think that's why we try to connect to the angels. So to stay positive most of the time, because the external world is not going to change. It's going to, I mean, there's going to be lots of surprises, and we all know that, I think, at this point in our lives, that there's always a new mistake. So you never really learn too much, you're always learning. So I think what we can do with ourselves is just change ourselves internally by healing ourselves. And who better than Shenazz to guide us through.
Yeah. I think that's so true. Very well spoken by Isha. Honestly, you can't change nothing and nobody. The only person you can change is yourself and the way you look and view a situation. And that is the most beautiful thing. Over to Isha.
Same thing?
Yes.
Okay. I think positivity for me is a way of living. It is a habit. It's very easy to think negative. It's, you know, like we learned in chemistry, protons and electrons, plus and minus is minus.
Yes.
So you have to, it has to be a habit. And it's very easy to think negative. But for me now, seeing is being. I believe that whatever I am, I attract. So I try to be as positive as possible, wow, because if that's how I am, everything is going to be beautiful. Everything is going to be positive.
How beautifully